Friends and family, welcome. On behalf of David and Nicole, I thank you for joining us on this joyous occasion. We are here to witness the creation of the most intimate of all relationships. We are here today to witness a marriage. Let us be honest enough to know that a true marriage is an inward bond of trust, friendship, and love that exists in the hearts of those that choose to spend their lives together. Only David and Nicole will truly know their marriage. Their partnership is their own to cultivate, and as their relationship grows, to be successful, they will need strength, courage, compassion, patience, and a really good sense of humor. As we all surely agree, these two possess all of those traits. Today, David and Nicole promise to embrace conflict as well as peace, to work as well as play, to give as well as receive, to be with, stay with, and move forward together. I'd like to speak a few words about David and Nicole and my meeting of both of them. Bear with me. David is the kind of person that will cheat to win an exhibition go-kart race in the intermission of a professional hockey game.
Yeah, that's true.
It is true. But David is also one of the most kind, caring, and selfless people that I have ever met in my entire life. He is the kind of guy that will not miss a friend's birthday party due to work obligations, and instead will rent a car, make a 14-hour drive to go to the birthday celebration, get back in the car, and go back to work. David has no clue how to work on a race car. But if you need help working on your race car, David will work on your race car. If you need help, he will find a way to help you. If you need something, he'll get it. His excuses for board game strategic failures are legendary, as are his reasons for losing fake digital racing. If you need help finishing your janky beer, Dave will assume his superhero persona of Richard Keister and finish your janky beer for you. These are all true stories. I am forever grateful that Dave is my friend. He makes the world a better place. Nicole.
Oh no.
I'm going to share with everybody the honest and true story of the first time that I ever met Nicole. At the time, she was living in Denver, David was living in Cincinnati, as was I. They had been seeing each other for a little while, but Dave's family and friends had not met Nicole. She came to Cincinnati to race, because we all race, in a large national sanctioned event, and also to meet Dave's friends and family on the side. As is common with our car hobby, that particular day, it was hot, windy, dusty, sweaty, and loud. Nicole showed up with perfect makeup, perfect hair, generally perfect everything. She was beautiful. And my first impression was, David, run away. Run very, very far away. My first impression is that Nicole was going to be high maintenance, difficult to deal with, and a whole lot of trouble. That is something that I knew from experience that my buddy Dave did not deal with very well. So I spent part of the morning trying to figure out how to tell Dave, Dave, no, run. But first impressions are often wrong, and mine was completely wrong. By the middle of that day, I decided that I liked Nicole a lot. By the time we all got to dinner that night, we were all laughing, drinking beer, and having a good time together while she enjoyed her new friends, eating the messiest hamburger on the menu while it dripped down her arm. I had fully transitioned from, Dave, run away, to, if you screw this up, I will punch you in the face. I actually think that's exactly what I told him.
Yeah, pretty much.
Pretty much.
Word for word.
Nicole is intelligent, gorgeous, funny, and in spite of her tendency to abuse tubes of oral care products in a very negligent way, she is a truly professional caregiver. I have had the opportunity to witness Nicole at her job, and I am to this day still floored at how good she is. I can only hope that if I am ever having the worst day of my life and I am in the hospital, Nicole is caring for me. She is my very good friend, and I'm a better person as a result. Aww. Nicole does also make the world a better place. Now, if everyone will please indulge, a reading by Katie Mekalevich.
Adapted from a classic English song. We are no strangers to love. Thou knowest the rules, and so do I. A true commitment is what I am looking for. You wouldn't find that in any other guy. I just want to tell us thou how I am feeling and make us thou understand. I'm never going to give us thou up, never going to let us thou down, never going to run around and desert thee. I'm never going to make us thou cry, never going to say goodbye, never going to tell a lie and desert thee. I'm never going to give us thou up.
David and Nicole will now share their vows.
Don't make me cry. Why else would I do this? Nicole, nearly 4 years ago, I traveled to Denver, Colorado to teach people how to drive cars through traffic cones faster. At the time, I had no idea that such a silly thing to do would cause such a gorgeous girl with a sweet car to come into my life and change it forever for the better. The first time you came to visit me in Ohio, I was waiting to pick you up at the airport and my stomach was in knots because I was so nervous. But by the end of the weekend, my friends had become your friends, as Scott said. We had all had a blast together, and I knew there was something very special between us. Now, fast forward 4 years, through a few dozen autocrosses and one miserably failed track day, hundreds of miles of bike rides, many 511s sent, several trips around the country together, a new home, new jobs, and by my count, I think just a tad over 6.2 million selfies, and I've learned there's no one else I could ever imagine loving as much as I love you. Our future will be even more amazing as we continue to build upon the foundations of what makes you and I so wonderful together. Told you I'd make you cry. Things won't always be easy. Our jobs may take us all over the country, but we'll continue to make the most of every opportunity that comes our way. So I promise to keep encouraging you to take that slalom flat, because seriously, the data shows that I took it flat, so I know that you can do it. So. I promise to clean up after all the new and creative ways you find to make the world's largest mess. But I also promise to be there by your side in the good times and the bad. I promise to live every day of my life trying to make your life better. And I vow you will always be the most important person in my life, because without you, I am nothing. But with you, I am more than myself. I give to you the best of me, my heart, and my soul, as long as we both shall live.
Thank you, David.
You want to read them for me?
Thank you.
Does anyone have a tissue?
You got this.
That's your job.
I know. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to do this.
Yes, you can.
David, I never truly understood what love was until you came into my life. 3 years ago, you took a chance on me and moved to Denver from your Cincinnati hometown. We spent the summer racing cars, rock climbing, and seeking new adventures together. It was then our relationship blossomed, and I knew you were the one. You're handsome, genuine, honest, and kind. You always seem to know how to do what's right. Each day, you inspire me to be a better person. I'm told marriage isn't easy, but life seems easier when we're together. David, you are my best friend, my anchor, my co-driver for life. I promise to unconditionally love and care for you, even when you're sick. Just please don't end up where I work. I promise to try my best to squeeze the toothpaste from the bottom of the tube instead of the middle.
Finally got solved.
I promise to keep cooking for you, especially if you keep cleaning up my path of destruction in the kitchen. I promise to listen to you and learn from you, to support you and accept your support. And lastly, I promise to always choose you each and every day in any lifetime, in any alternate universe. I know I would find you and choose you over and over again. Dave, I choose you as the person with whom I will spend my life. I love you, And I'm yours for as long as we both shall live.
Thank you. Ryan's got you.
Thank you.
I'm gonna give you a second. You ready? As many of you may know, both David and Nicole have an appreciation for very fine craft beers. In lieu of the traditional candles or sand, David and Nicole now celebrate their new marriage with a Unity beer. Nicole, fittingly, this is going to be difficult. You want to help her out? Nicole, fittingly, has chosen a raspberry ale, which is sweet, fun, a little bit tart, and generally well-liked. David has chosen an India Pale Ale, which is citrusy and earthy and can be a bit bitter. It's an acquired taste, but people that tend to like it really like it. David and Nicole have both grown to appreciate this family of beers, and they will share that together. These are both great on their own, but mixed together, they become something new, unique, and delicious. Just as these two beers have been combined together and are now impossible to separate, so may your marriage be united for a lifetime. May we have the rings.
That's so cute.
You're gonna have to free them up.
Sorry, I'm new at this.
Do you want me to hold the shell in your time?
Sure. I'm not gonna drop them. I'm gonna do that one. And I'll take this one. Thank you.
Do you, David, take Nicole to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
Please place the ring on Nicole's finger.
Uh-oh. Push hard.
There we go.
You can do it.
Tell me with this.
Do you, Nicole, take David to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
Please place the ring on David's finger.
Be gentle. Twist.
Your fingers got fat.
Keep pushing. You're almost there. There we go. Okay. Okay.
You may now kiss your bride.
Yay!
By the power invested in me, by the state of North Carolina, I now pronounce you man and wife. Ladies and gentlemen, I present David and Nicole Santel.